center of discussion is the headache. Why headache has been very important and why headache happens, okay? So this is one thing, that the headache is the pain in the head. Actually, what happens is that inside the brain there is not the pain. There is the, this is the pain that is outside the, due to the stimulation or the receptors outside the brain. Are you getting my point? That in headache is inside brain, but its actual cause is receptors present outside the brain. For example, there are due to very reason. There are two very important types of the headache. That is the primary headache and the secondary headache. And the primary headache, we will see that what is going on in the primary headache and what is going on in the secondary headache. What, how is the treatment of the of that specific thing. So one thing, one point is that brain is insensitive to, actually brain itself is insensitive to pain. Brain itself is insensitive to pain. One thing. Second thing is, it gets the stimulation from receptors outside the brain. These are very important points. That's why I wrote it on the board. Okay, so you people must know that brain is actually insensitive to pain, but there for the pain you have to get the receptors. Okay, the receptors are present outside the brain, and outside the brain they will get the stimulus, and then they will be like the disease will be, or the pain will be felt. Okay, let me tell you a story before that, that how in actual life we have to deal with that of the headache, because it's the very common phenomena. Like every day you get a headache. Not if you don't get every day, then after some days or like monthly or sometimes you get that headache. This is a very common disease. What happens is that you have got some kind of relation with the other diseases. You may have the actual headache, or you may have the trauma or the injury that would lead to the headache. So these are different kinds of the headache, that whatever the cause is, that will release the chemical substances at the neurotransmitters, at the neurotransmitter junction or the neural junctions, and then they will send the signals or send the release of the neurotransmitters that will trigger into that of the brain. For example, you have got this. Okay, where I have to. There, this is the. This is the brain, but you have got the other nerves supplying within the brain. For example, any of the nerve that you go, for example, trigeminal, which is the fifth nerve. So trigeminal, what it does is it will stimulate and it will do it will cause the release of neurotransmitter over here, and the other nerve which are the other neurons which are present, they will take that information and they will spread into the other parts of the brain, and then they will be thrombing over there and there would be the pain over there. The pain receptor is actually outside the central nervous system, outside the brain, but it will go into that of the brain as a stimulation. Okay, so this is one thing. Now moving on to the thing, that there are the two types of the headache, which is the primary and other is primary headache, and there is the secondary headache. Primary headache, you can see that we have got the pain at a very early onset, and we can have different types of the pain, which is the migraine, which is the tension, which could be the hormonal, and which could be the sinusitis, and which may be due to the clusters. One by one we will see that how the pain is present. Okay, for example, you have got the beautiful hair of the person, beautiful hair, and here must be served. Okay, what happens is that migraine would be unilateral or bilateral. There is the first point I talked about, that is the migraine. Okay, that would be unilateral, one-sided, or this could be the bilateral. Okay, in the migraine, I'm just talking about the general thing. Okay, the types I will discuss it later on. But up till now, I'm talking about that the primary headache will have the migraine, and migraine would be unilateral, and it may be the bilateral thing. This has a general onset, and this would be recurrent. This has a general onset, and this would be recurrent, and it could happen in the 4 to 72 hours. This is recurrent, this is general onset from slow to gradual. You will feel that much pain that you can say that how we are going to deal with it. Okay, so this is one thing that is the migraine, and this may be due to the trigeminal nerve which is present within that of the within that of the central nervous system, that is coming from outside and is providing the facial part, which is providing the maxillary part, and it is providing the mandibular part. So this may be due to that reason, and there's so many other reasons of the migraines, we will discuss that, but for the sake of easiness, I'm just telling about you the general thing. Then there might be a second thing, which is the tension could be anywhere. Tension is due to the girlfriend. Okay, so this may lead to the severe headaches, and for some people they think that girlfriends are the headaches, but for some of the people, like they still see the girls, so their tension is released. So I don't know what kind of things are that, but we will discuss that things even. Okay, so don't take this thing in a hilarious manner. This is also a part of our medical thing, that how we are going to study. So tension is also a thing that will lead to the headache. This is bilateral, and this can maybe for variable time it will. If you get the tension today, you got something something very tense news, then you can you don't know how to deal with it, then you can get the tension, and from the tension you can get the headache. So this is the second thing which may the on general which is any time, variable time. You want this thing. Now the third thing is sinusitis means the sinusoids, which are present paranasal sinuses, and there are different frontal sinuses, and there are so many sinuses. So due to the sinal infections there would be the headache, because they are closely related with that of the brain. Due to the reason that their nerves are supplying, and nerves are interconnected between them. Okay, that's why headache happens over there. Sinusitis infection over there. So this is maybe sinusitis infection by different bacteria, by different viruses, because there is the sinus fluid, synovial fluid will be presenting over there, and if there is infection over there, then you may have the headache. Then third is the clusters. For example, there is the clusters, means that this is the idiopathic headache. Like you don't know what is actually the cause, but you will feel that this is the idiopathic. You don't actually know the cause, but there is a quick pain and unilateral, and it may continue from 30 minutes to 4 hours. So this is the quick pain. Suddenly you start the pain, feeling the pain. This is the fourth one, which is the clustral, and the fifth one, which is a very important, and this is the hormonal. Fifth one is the hormonal. For example, this is unilateral. What happens is hormonal headache. Why? What? Due to the menstruation cycle, the time of the menstruation cycle, or at the time you've got the estradiol and the estrogen, actually estrogen and progesterone, they are present. So due to the variation of estrogen and progesterone, this will lead to that of the headache. So many of the females, they got the headache in the premenstrual cycle. So that may also be the cause of the headache. Okay. So and then there is also one thing, that is the Horner's disease. Horner's disease may be in the clusters. Horner's disease means that you have got the ptosis, and ptosis means the drooping of the eyelid. Okay. Dropping of the eyelid, and there would be meiosis too in present between the Horner's disease. Horner's disease we will discuss in detail when we will talk about the in the further lectures we will talk about. In this disease, you know, lacrimation would be there, salivation would be there, and the nasal discharge would be more. So there are so many things that are related with the headache. So all these conditions will lead to the headache inside our inside our brain. Okay.
Can you explain the last one?
Ptosis. Okay, Horner's disease is actually a disease which is which in this disease there would be, there may be the dropping of the eyelids, and that dropping of the eyelids is called as the ptosis. Don't see ptosis, say this is the ptosis. Okay, so meiosis is also a disease that would be presenting in that of the Horner's disease. We will discuss the Horner's disease in detail, but up till now we don't have to confuse this thing. Okay. Now, the secondary headache would have the systemic symptoms or the chronic effects or the above the age there starts. Secondary means that later onset. Okay, so there would be the snook, that is the snook. This leads to systemic headache. There would be the nasal. Neurological symptoms, that you have got something going on wrong in your brain, so there would be neurological symptoms. There would be the onset at late age, that could be greater than 40, and then there would be the OTC, like you're taking the drugs which are the, we have the other features, like different diseases accumulate and form the cause the headache. Because headache is itself not a disease, it is due to the other stimulation that will lead to the headache. So other features would be there. Okay. And then the last one is the previous headache. Like you have headache, you have been having the headache for so long, and now it continues permanently. That would be the secondary headache. So up till now, are you getting what I was teaching? Okay. Now let me tell you what is the treatment of the headache. When in the migraine, you can give the aspirin or NSAIDs. Okay. And you know, this is due to the reason that there would be the vasodilations. So vasodilations are too much vasodilation. So we will give the aspirin and the NSAIDs over there. And you can also give the antimimetic drugs. Why we give the antimimetic drugs? Do you remember antimimetic drugs? Antimimetic drugs are the nausea drugs or the vomiting drugs. So in the vomiting and the nausea, we give the antimimetic drugs. In the tension, you give the Panadol. Over, that is OTC. Over the counter, you can give the Panadol. So if you got the tension and you got the headache, then you can have the Panadol, which is a good thing. And the sinusitis, there would be the antimimetic drugs. There would be the antimimetic drugs, and then there would be also the antibiotics. Antibiotics, there will be anti-analgesics. And this is the thing, just normally the sinusitis infection itself, obviously if there is nasal nasal infection, any infection over there, they must have the drugs for them. So just give that drugs, and just give the antimimetic drugs if you got the vomiting and antibiotics for that, so that your headache might resolve. And hormonal, how to treat hormonal thing, you but in the days you can do it, that you have to balance the hormonal level. Just to balance the hormonal level, this will reside the headache. Okay, so this is the treatment of the hormonal headache. What about the clusters? In the clusters, you must give the oxygen and oxygen plus the tryptophan. this is the thing that you have done. Then this will cause the resolution of the headache. And in what else left? Nothing left. So this was the thing, and then the treatment. This is the cluster disease. So you might have been given that. So this was about the headache and the like the normal thing which we were discussing about the pain. So let's divide the headache now. How headache is divided? Headache is actually divided into five important things. That is migraine headache, then there is the cerebral injury that will lead to headache, then there is the due to other diseases, which is the nasal or the sinuses infection, there would be the disease, and then there would be the
there is headache due to the cerebral trauma.
Okay, cerebral injury we have done. Then there is a meningeal headache. And fifth one, which is the very important, this is the alcoholic headache. You take alcohol and you get the headache. So migraine headache, I already talked about that there is due, this is due to the unilateral, this could be unilateral, this could be bilateral, and the viral infections if they are present, and that will be causes the vasoconstriction of the cerebral arteries supplying the vertical visual cortex. So what happens is that if you have to treat the migraine, you have to lessen the vasodilation. In the migraine, what happens is there is a very increased vasodilation. You have to resolve that thing. You have to bring the vessels normal. That will resolve the migraine. Okay. This is one thing. Now, what the thing is? Second is the cerebral. Do you have any question?
Migraine vasodilation.
Yes, this is due to the vasodilation. Then there is the extra vasodilation. And okay, let me tell you. There are the simple areas from where the arteries passes by. Okay, but what happens is if there is vasodilation, then the foramen or the that particular part cannot be like increased. At this point. Okay. Now, for example, you have got this area for the passing of the vessel. But what if there is the increased, if there is vasodilation, it cannot, the area would remain the same at point, but still there are the pain receptors at this area that will cause the pain stimulation, and you feel that there is the pain. So you just do is that bring the vessel normal, vasoconstriction, or actually bring the resolve the vasodilation, then this would be removed, like this would become normal. Then second is the cerebral injury. If you get the direct cerebral injury, you are hit by something, you are hit by by any kind of stuff, so that would cause the increased intracranial pressure. You remember CSF. So if it is intracranial pressure is raised, then this will lead to the irritation and the stretching of the dura mater, and then you can have the cerebral injury. What about the nasal secretion and the nasal infection? Like if there is any infection, I already talked about that there is the infection that will lead to the headache. Dental, and in this there could be the dental problems. They would irritate the trigeminal nerve. In this whole thing, there would be irritating the trigeminal nerve, because the trigeminal nerve in the upper part, this will provide the facial. Okay, are the upper? Okay, let me describe you the thing. For example, at this part here, they would be this part is supplied by trigeminal nerve frontal part. This part is supplied by the nasal part, or we can say the maxillary part, and there would be the mandibular part. Okay, so these three are the
are the part of the trigemina. One is going to facial, one is going to the medulla, maxilla, and other is going to that of the mandible. Okay, so these trigeminal nerves provide the three pathways, and if there is any kind of like irritation or the stimulation at this point, then this will may irritate that nucleus, and this may release the neurotransmitter and will cause the throbbing and the headache. So this was about the nasal. This is just the dental or any kind of, you know, the other things, sinuses or any part of the disease that will cause the headache. Then there is a meningeal headache. You remember I talked about that if there is the direct trigeminal nerve which is supplying, there is the vagal nerve which is supplying, and there is three cervical nerves which are supplying that of the dura mater. And if there is any kind of injury in that portion, like, you know, three kinds of the nerves are providing, then you might have the severe headache, which is the meningeal headache. And the below the tentorium we have the innervations of the cervical nerves, and due to the meningitis you can also have the disease which with the head. In the meningitis we also talked about there is the severe headache and the thing, and also there would be the nausea, vomiting and photophobia presenting over there. So this is the meningeal headache. And last, which is the alcoholic headache. Alcoholic has the direct toxic effect on that of the brain, which is due to the direct toxic effect on the meninges. So alcohol is directly related with that of the meninges, and in fact that, and they say, will lead to the headache inside our brain. So the treatment is according to the location or according to the thing. In alcoholic headache, you have to stop the alcohol, and you have to give the patient any kind of the, like, this over-the-counter drugs, and you may let the person sleep. And if one person is slept, then you can say that the patient would have the resolvement of that thing. Now, the thing is, when there is also a kind that sometimes you don't sleep and you feel the headache, okay, you don't sleep for a while, or you work very delicately, or you work very focusedly, or you are reading very small substances or small things on the page, so you might have this kind of the other diseases headache. Okay, so this is the thing, that when you so much focused, when you're so much focused, your neurons are overfiring. Your neurons, at this point, your neurons are overfiring, and it will stimulate extra and extra neurons, and it will go into the brain, and the head will throb, and you feel that there is the headache, because there would be the extra stimulation. So if there is action potential, then there would be the abnormal action potential, and it will increase the thing that. So this will also the thing. So I was talking about the wakefulness and the sleepiness. What happens is, then when you work for a very long time, so at the time comes when you're overstimulation of the neurons, and you feel like you are done with this, and you are saying that no, we cannot stay anymore. Okay, so that is the point when you feel, when your body starts to know that now you have to take the sleep, cause your neurons are overfiring, they need to have the rest for that. Okay, so this is the this is one thing. Now another thing which the migraine. I forgot to tell you, the migraine is more common in the females as compared to that of the males. Okay, so this might be the reason that females are so much talking every time and saying this and that to another person. To one lady, she will go and say, don't tell to other. And the other lady will say, don't tell to other. I was just, last night, I was just watching the video in which there was a person, she was saying that I had a stomach ache. I cannot do anything to his husband. She was saying that, and his husband said, okay, let's go to the hospital. He said, no, I don't want to go to the hospital. I just want to go to that my friend's house. So he was shocked to know that when he take him her to her friend's home, then she told all the story that she did that, and, you know, backbiting. Then she felt, okay, now I'm my head. My stomach ache is good. So that was a funny part, that headache, her stomach ache was due to the thing that she had something in her gut, so she had to tell someone. So at that point, that girl that was her friend listening, she also got the headache. She wants to go to another friend's house to tell that it was. So this was just a part of joke, don't take it serious. So girls, I have more migraine than that of the males. Okay, this is not the actual reason. The viewers over sitting over there, the students, my students, don't write it on your notes that females have the migraine, more migraine due to this reason. This is just due to the reason that females have got the menstruation cycles, so their hormonal levels are upset all the time. So that's why they get the headache more. So this was the thing. And now there would be the genetic thing. There could be the genetic. Like for your in the brain, you have got very minute receptors. So the three sodium goes out in the three sodium comes in the two potassium goes out. The potassium at the back of the cells at the back of the potassium. So the potassium has to go outside. Some of the times, what happens is that the receptor is not proper. You see?
Okay. What happens is, for example, you have got this thing in which you can send the 3 sodium inside and 2 potassium outside. At the same point, you have got the calcium channels in which you constantly give calcium and have the calcium outside. It's just general thing. What happens is, one of the receptors got defective. This one.
The inside going is corrected, is right, but this one is, the outside coming is not the outside coming is increased and inside is not increased. One of the receptors is defective. What happens is there is the greater accumulation on one side of the calcium. This would lead to the extra stimulation of the action potential. And if there is increase and if there is genetic defect of that receptor, then you can say the person might have the migraine. This is the genetic migraine that will, from parents to parents, from their some family members, all of them have the migraine. This could be genetic. And second thing, that is, there could be the cortical spreading depression, and there would be the central sensitization, that is the chronic one. And this is the big things that we will discuss later on, but for the basic general knowledge of the headache, we just want to talk about this. Are you satisfied with that, what you have been studying? Are you with me? Do you have any questions?
Yes. No.
Aspirin is the vasodilator or constrictor?
What? Aspirin is actually, what happens is that this is important in the inhibition of the pathway of prostaglandins. So what is the prostaglandins? Prostaglandins was actually the vasodilator. Yes, actually, prostaglandin is a vasodilator. So what happens is that it will vasodilator. It will inhibit this pathway. You remember this arachnoid? This is what I'm talking about. There would be the phospholipase that would be forming, and the end product. The end product would be the prostaglandin. Blending. So in this pathway, there is the inhibition of the aspirin. So this is the vasodilator. So this will inhibit the vasodilation. So there would be the vasoconstriction, which we needed in the migraine. Okay. Are you getting what I taught? Any questions? Further questions? Done. Okay. Let's move on. Now we will discuss about the cerebrospinal fluid and the ventricular system and the cerebrospinal fluid. Up till now, we are done with this.